Hello, I'm Janice with Wake County Public Libraries, and I'd like to welcome you to our virtual Music in the Library program featuring Andrew Kasab. Wake County Public Libraries is committed to creating and presenting programs that support the arts and lifelong learning in a virtual environment. You can connect with us anytime on our website at wakegov.com/libraries. Now, I'm pleased to present Raleigh musician Andrew Kasab. He'll be playing a harp guitar and pausing at times to tell us a little about his story and this unique instrument. Thank you for attending. Here is Andrew Kasab.
My name's Andrew Kasab, and this right here is a harp guitar. The harp guitar is an instrument that originates from Europe around the late 1700s and the early 1800s. They took the standard classical guitar and they would add on extra strings to kind of make the range a little bit bigger. And this was a standard sort of practice around that time period because the guitar wasn't formally standardized until about the 1860s. Now, one of the things that was really nice with this too is it meant that you could fill in the space of a couple of players in a group, and this was widely used in a lot of European music. The contra guitar was the primary instrument that took shape in the mid-1800s. Around the late 1800s into the early 1900s, the harp guitar took shape in the United States as a steel-stringed instrument, and the Larson brothers, under the direction of Chris Knutson up in the upper Midwest of the United States, started to add steel strings to the instrument to make it sound a little bit more vibrant as metallurgy came along a little bit more, and they were able to make the tension and match with the body and hold its pitch. That's where this instrument took hold into basically the shape that you see that I'm holding here today. And this is where I have 6 normal strings, and then I also have 6 sub-bass strings that enhance the range of the instrument. There's a couple of notable players through the modern history of the harp guitar. They would be Michael Hedges from the 1980s, Stephen Bennett, who's still around, he's been playing since the 1980s as well, and other younger artists such as Andy McKee and myself. This is a piece by Michael Hedges that he wrote called The Double Planet, and it incorporates a lot of progressive as well as traditional ways to pluck this instrument. Take a listen. Thank you. This is a piece that I wrote called Fireflies, and it was about catching fireflies in a nice summer day, pretty much kind of like what you might catch around this time of year. It's pretty fun. I know I had my son at a wedding years ago where we were out and in the field with the other kids in between all the toasts and whatnot, and he was there with the other children catching fireflies and putting them in their pockets of their dress shirts because they didn't really have a mason jar or anything to put it in. So be sure to go out and catch some fireflies. And this is a piece that I wrote that incorporates a little bit more standard sort of ideas that you might find on a guitar. This is a wonderful little piece that I wrote that kind of encapsulates the sound of falling leaves as they would swirl around. I was sitting in a house and looking outside and watching the leaves fall and thinking it'd be nice to maybe go out and rake them, or I could just sit inside and write a song. This right here, this piece also uses some more progressive ideas. And this is where my left hand is doing something so that it frees up what my right hand can do, which is not typically done on a guitar. Usually both hands work together in concert so that they can create the tones together. But in this, here I'm using each hand individually. Since there isn't a whole lot of music that's written directly for the harp guitar, a lot of times harp guitarists like myself end up having to adapt other pieces that have been done by players. One of the things that I find that's also really good is to adapt players' pieces that were done originally as a progressive style on the guitar, and then to take that and swoop it over to the harp guitar and then expand upon it with the sub-bass strings. This is a piece by an Italian artist named Peppino Di Agostino called Echoes of Delphi Valley, which is a valley in Greece that evidently has a lot of resonance to it, and the piece tries to get that sort of feeling in it. By adding the harp guitar in there, I'm adding in a little bit more resonance as well, because the lower strings, whether they're plucked or not, also resonate. And you can hear this if I strum a little bit and then stop the guitar strings, you'll still hear the sub-bass strings carry. This is one of the big features of the harp guitar, because it has such a large acoustic body that it allows the strings to resonate a little bit more on their own unless they're stopped with either my palm or my left hand. But generally, I think it's nice to make them ring out, especially when they make the song sound a little bit more voluminous. Thank you. In this tuning that I have the harp guitar in right now, it really centers around what is traditionally an Irish tuning. And this is what sometimes guitarists refer to as dadgad, because the strings are tuned to D, A, D, G, A, D. Now, a lot of those Irish traditional songs or carolan songs, that they're sometimes adapted to the guitar where they have that dadgad. And then of course, what I can also do now is enhance that again with the lower strings, whether they're being plucked or not, which is fine because in a lot of Irish music, you might also hear that those lower strings are continued on kind of like a droning string, similar to what you might hear in banjo music in American culture. This is a piece that I wrote that has a little bit of a percussive edge to it, and it still works that same dadgad tuning like was in the other Peppino di Agostino piece, and also a little bit of that sort of more progressive flair of it.
Thank you.
This is another adapted piece by Peppino D'Agostino. And the one thing that I like with this one especially is that, again, it works that left hand and that right hand very individually. Plus, it has a little bit of a change where it segues into a little bit more traditional guitar-like sort of sound. To me, one of the things that's very important with this instrument is to try to not only adapt other works by significant progressive instrumentalists, but also to see that I can enhance the sound of it by using the lower reaches of the harp guitar strings, and then also to make the traditional guitar strings still sing. This is his piece called Acoustic Spirit. One of the last things that I think is very important to see on the guitar is to take very popular melodies and be able to turn them into something that's a little bit more orchestrated for a band, now down to one instrument. And to me, this is really, I think, what we can see that happens on a lot of solo guitar pieces. And then, of course, with the expanded range of the harp guitar, definitely makes it a little bit more fun as well. This is a pretty well-known piece, and you're more than welcome to sing along.
Thank you so much, Andrew, for an amazing performance, and thank you to our viewers for attending this virtual Music in the Library. Stay tuned to our website, wakegov.com/libraries, for the most up-to-date information. Thank you.